Locomotive was the song, and it's pretty, it's a lot of changes in it.
Yeah.
I guess they thought that I'd be all right for that, for a guest spot. That I wrote initially. I mean, I write everything for Guns, yeah. You know, and sometimes, especially when Steve was in the band, you know, some stuff was definitely too funky,
yeah.
And so we just didn't use it. And so now, having Guns play it, I was like, you guys don't even realize how funny this is.
So they just showed up to watch Jeff play, you know, and then we just got everyone out there. We had never really rehearsed it or anything.
Here's a look at how rehearsals went yesterday at the Hippodrome de Vincennes. Right now we're down at Le Dumago, a classic Parisian cafe and one-time hangout of such famous philosophers and writers as Jean-Paul Sartre and Simone de Beauvoir. We're going to take a quick break right here, during which time you might want to call your local cable operator and sign up for the Guns N' Roses pay-per-view concert, which is just moments away, actually. For the first time in their career, Guns N' Roses are playing Paris, the Hippodrome de Vincennes, to be exact, before a local audience of some 40,000 fans and an estimated 200,000 households in 14 countries that will be watching the pay-per-view concert via satellite.
It's the only reason we're doing it is because it's a vehicle for us to get our show out to a bunch of people that don't have the opportunity to see it. So that's that.
And also, I might want to add, it's not a, like a profit-motivated thing for us to make money. It's just for kids that, because we're only playing in certain towns and certain places, and kids that don't get to see us and can't afford it and can't make it, it gives them an opportunity to see us. So yeah. I hope it all works out great.
Guns N' Roses aren't complete pay-per-view rookies. Axl Rose and former Guns guitarist Izzy Stradlin joined the Rolling Stones for a song during the Stones' own cable special back in December of 1989. And Guns will have some special guests of their own for this Parisian broadcast, chief among them former Yardbirds guitar legend Jeff Beck. Singer Lenny Kravitz will be doing his own Always on the Run, a song on which Slash played guitar. And Steven Tyler and Joe Perry of Aerosmith, a group.
We're going to be playing some places that we never played before, like Prague, Czechoslovakia, and Hungary, and then we're going to Spain, Portugal, and it's the first time for Guns N' Roses in Italy, I believe. When we played Wembley,